Welcome again. Right now we're at 1 Corinthians chapter 6, and we're reading verse 12 all the way through to the end of the chapter, verse 20. Paul is talking about sexual immorality. All things are lawful for me, but not all things are expedient. All things are lawful for me, but I will not be brought under the power of anything. Foods for the belly and the belly for foods, but God will bring to nothing both it and them. But the body is not for sexual immorality. Boom. Thank you, Paul. But for the Lord, and the Lord for the body. Now God raised up the Lord, and will also raise us up by his power. Don't you know that your bodies are members of Christ? In other words, your bodies are parts of his body. You are parts of the body of Christ. Shall I then take the members of Christ and make them members of a prostitute? May it never be. But don't you know that he who is joined to a prostitute is one body? This is the whole idea of one flesh. You know, it says that two will be joined together and become one flesh. One flesh does not happen when you just magically sign your name on a piece of paper, on a certificate or legal document, or make a vow. That's not what makes you one flesh. One flesh is when you are joined with somebody physically. Don't you know that he who is joined to a prostitute is one body? For the two, he says, will become one flesh. Genesis chapter 2, verse 24, Paul quotes the Torah again. But he who is joined to the Lord is one spirit. Flee sexual immorality. Every sin that a man does is outside the body, but he who commits sexual immorality sins against his own body. Or don't you know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit who is in you, whom you have from God? And we talked about this not so long ago. You've got to be very careful how you treat your body, because your body is the temple of God. Can you imagine if you were to go into the temple or the tabernacle in Moses' day, you know, and write on the wall or something like that? Man, you'd probably die right away. I mean, don't do anything disrespectful to God's temple, especially your body, because at this point in time, if you are born again, if you truly have the Spirit of God living within you, you are a temple of the Spirit of God. Don't abuse, do not defile and destroy God's temple by junk food, by smoking, by recreational drugs, or anything else that could destroy your health. Take care of yourself. Take care of God's temple. Paul says down here, you are not your own, for you were bought with a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's. And this is the whole thing in the abortion debate. You know, a lot of women say, well, it's my body, I can do whatever I want with it. Listen, there's so much wrong with that, okay? First of all, that so-called tissue within you is not your tissue, okay? It does not match your DNA. That DNA has its own personal profile, which is not yours. It's not your body. God made your womb to be the safest place. Talk about safe spaces. Yes, God made your womb to be the safest place for that baby. Don't make it a war field. Second of all, if you're truly a believer, if you're truly a Christian, Paul says here, even your body, even if it was, okay, let's give you the benefit of the doubt. Let's say it is your body. Well, listen, God says you are not your own. Your body is really not your body. It's God's body. Therefore, glorify God with your body. If you're truly a believer, if you're truly born again, God purchased you. You were bought with a price. Don't say my body, my this and my that. No, God's, okay? You do it God's way, not your way. Seek God with all your heart. And if you do, you will find him. Call upon him and he will show you great and mighty things. Love you guys.